In the first part of this series, I introduced you to the iMovie workspace and showed how to import media. In the second part of this tutorial, we're going to begin building a video using our imported files. I've already created a new project which can be seen in the project library. Double-click to open. Now we can begin adding media to build our video project. I'm going to use some footage that I shot at one of the northernmost stands of mangroves. These are tropical trees on the island of Yakushima in Japan. And I think I'll start this clip right here showing a group of trees. These tropical trees are stunted, by the way, because they are growing very slowly in this subtropical climate. Go farther north and you won't find any mangroves because the climate is too cold for them. Okay, you can see that this clip is 17.4 seconds in duration. And we can preview it by placing the playhead, this is that moving vertical line, at the beginning of that clip and manually scrubbing across the clip. And you can see what's happening in the viewer window. Or to play it, we just tap the space bar on our computer keypad. And you can see that it plays in the viewer window. If we want to add the entire clip, we can double-click to select it. The clip is outlined in yellow, and a plus sign appears. Then all we have to do is just click the plus sign, and the entire clip drops into the timeline. Notice that now there is an orange line on the clip in the media library showing what you just added. This comes in handy to keep track of what clips you've used in your project. What if we want to add only a portion of a clip? We click once and then drag to highlight a portion of the clip. As we drag, we can see the duration in seconds. To add the selection to the timeline, we can again click the plus sign and the clip drops into the timeline at the end. Let's add one more clip. Select the segment as before, but this time I want to insert the clip not at the end, but between the first two clips. To do this, I drag the selected clip segment into the timeline and position the cursor between those clips and then release. If you change your mind, just highlight the clip in the timeline by double-clicking and hit the delete button on your keyboard. The clip is removed. You can also undo any action by selecting Edit, then Undo. Or use the keyboard shortcut for undo, which is Command-Z on a Mac. That deleted clip is back. We can move clips around by double-clicking to select, then drag to another position in the timeline. Periodically review your project by clicking the play button below the viewer panel or just tap your space bar. Once you get several clips in the timeline, it gets harder to see all of them. You can change the number of frames visible in each clip in the timeline by moving this scroll bar. You can see the clips getting shorter or longer. This doesn't affect the duration, just the number of frames you can see in the timeline. By the way, none of these changes will affect your original video files. Now you can see what we are doing. As each clip is added to the timeline, we add another part to the story we are building. You'll continue adding clips like this to complete your video. In part 3 of this tutorial, we'll look at how to modify clips.